Hey, what's up, girls? Your boy G Trump, everybody, favorite baby daddy, the voice of the street, man. And today we in. We gonna be in Mississippi with y'all. Now, look, ladies, let me just say this. Because men, when people speak, they speak from the heart. So if he said, I come out his mouth, it's in his heart. Trust me, right? If a man ever tell you, I'm gonna kill you, you need to stop fucking with him. Calm the situation down from that point and then just ease back up off of him. Because that's something you never supposed to say to somebody. And then if he a hothead, like we going to Mississippi, y'all, and I'm gonna let y'all hear what the news people say. Like everybody else, you got a baby daddy, and not you, I guess you don't think. This is what I look at. I guess you never would think your baby daddy will harm you to the point where you dead, you know? Not only did this man kill his baby mama, he killed his baby mama, her two friends, and then killed himself. It was a little girl in the car. He didn't kill her. But they said her mama tried to shield her, or somebody tried to cover up, and that's probably why. But he shot everybody in the fucking head. And then himself. That's some built up anger. You had to see this coming some type of way. Now they've been up and down, but damn, to the point where I'm gonna kill you? Man, listen to this, what the news say.
Members tell me that they are heartbroken after this shooting.
I've never seen nothing like that before.
Family's torn apart. We are broken.
One victim's auntie, Nancy Stewart, says her nephew went by a nickname, Nate. Neighbor Joe Wilson used to take Nate to school many years ago. He describes to us what he heard.
Instantly after the first three or four, it sounded like another three or four shots.
The names of the four victims, a man and woman from Holly Springs and two women from Memphis, have been confirmed.
Investigators in Marshall County believe 27-year-old Nathan Stewart fired the fatal shots. Mm-hmm. Deputies say that three-year-old witnessed them. Her mother, 23-year-old Siobhan Murray, 23-year-old Sharde Trevino, and 23-year-old Victoria Pugh.
This heinous and cowardly act led to a major...
Now, all that, this man killed all these people and then killed himself. You got to pay attention to people, man, how they treat themselves. Do they value life? What could a person do to you to make you that mad? Well, I'm going to kill you and everybody in the car. You see, like, all these... These the bitches be instigating. These the women that tell me, stop fucking with you. But what they do, bro? Really? I can't believe that. But then again, I can back it up. Remember I said that in my last video. I said, man, it seemed like that's the answer to all our problems. Oh, you want to break up? I'm going to kill you then, bitch. Oh, you don't want to go in? I'm going to kill you. Oh, I'm fired? I'm going to kill you. Every problem can't be solved the same way, y'all. Come on, man. We got to start trying to grow up. But it's hard for these younger people because you got to become an adult to be able to control your anger and your emotions. That's not an easy thing to do because you get upset and you fly off the handle. But, you know, the older you get, dial your gangster down. Every year, the older you get, you dial your gangster down, and then you become more laid back, humble, you know, less of a problem. You learn how to communicate. Fellas, learn how to communicate better with a woman, and you won't be willing to choke her to death and kill her all the damn time. Sometimes this conversation, see, and that's another thing I said too, y'all. That's why I really hate this new age shit, this texting. These motherfuckers walk around here emotionless. Emotionless. That's why I still like talking on the telephone. Hello, I want to hear you talking. Hey, how you doing? I'm having a bad day. Yeah, I can hear that. Motherfucker, you can text me and tell me anything. hey, how you doing? And she's sitting there, anything going on. People got to get back closer, man, so we don't be just killing each other. We're going to have sad scenes like this. Beautiful women, too, y'all. I'm going to put the thumbnail up. Beautiful women. I'm going to take a picture of this so you can see. Sometimes people get jealous of you. People get jealous, even somebody you sleeping with. Some people call themselves love you, but don't want to see you happy. You hear me? I'm going to say that again. Some people can call themselves love you, but don't want to see you happy. And what I mean by that is, he loves you, you his woman, but every time you come around the corner and you smiling, joking, fuck you smiling there, who you talking to? You know, you like, damn, nigga, I can't be happy. Somebody told a joke. Fuck you laughing at their jokes for you. You don't laugh at my joke because it ain't funny. You ain't said nothing funny, nigga. Hit that like button, y'all. Subscribe to the channel, man. This is crazy. Let me know what y'all thinking. Did y'all see this story? This is wild, man. This is really wild, man. I want to pray for this family, man. And the little girl still alive. She sainted. Grandma says she tried to rape mommy up, but she couldn't do it. That's a hurtful feeling, y'all. I had another video I had did, and it touched me up. I almost started crying. I was telling that story. You know, a little girl standing over her daddy. When the police get there, she got blood all over there, and all she wants the police to do is wake up her daddy. Wake up her daddy. And she's looking like he won't get up. He won't get up. And this is what she's trying to get the police doing. Police looking like, oh, shit. No, he ain't getting up, baby. He dead. That little girl learning about life and death now, because they go have to explain to her, your mommy ain't gonna be able to wake up. Daddy put her to sleep forever. And daddy gone to sleep? Yeah, him and her gone to sleep. You know, however you go try to fix it up, but... And then we wonder why people be so evil in life. You don't be knowing what type of trauma people have had in their life. And you might be sitting here saying like I'm saying, what the fuck wrong with this boy? His uncle might have did the same thing. His daddy might have did something like this. It's something be going on and we need to sometimes. That's why you talk to people. Ask them about their lives. How was your childhood? Why you don't talk to your brother? Why you don't talk to your sister? Find out what's going on. That make for better relationships. You know, that make for better relationships. Earlier, I was looking at somebody asking me what I thought about the little boy. Not the little boy. The video of Aunt Glizzy dissing Chicago and all 63rd over there. I'm like, he just doing that for attention, y'all. He just, you know, he been talking shit to them and just to be doing it. I don't know why people get on the internet and want to just play and tease people. He want to get somebody to respond. When people ask me, what you think about it? I'm like, I don't give no fuck about it. I'm from Chicago, but I got nothing to do with it. I don't entertain goofy shit. You know what I mean? That's what we would call goofy shit. I don't entertain goofy shit. So he wants to be a clown and be in the circus. Let him be a clown by his damn self. You know, he talked about Duck. He talking about Duck didn't survive. He said Cash got set up by a bitch. Lil' J in jail sucking dick. And Butter make him look like shit. Yeah, well, all them people have flaws in their own character. Hey, that's how they look at it. You know, people crack up and be talking about Jay. He in jail, he doing what he do. Hey, y'all know that nigga gay. If y'all didn't know it, y'all should know it by now. And Butter just weird. But Butter dialing his gangster back a little bit too. You know, And then I see Yella talking to the nigga. And then J-Man did a video with the nigga S.A.T.'s. So they be just playing, man. These niggas just playing. Because don't y'all know the wilder people make this shit, the more people watch it, the more money you basically make. You know, I could fake a shootout over here and watch the number. They shot up the studio yesterday, man. Let me see. People want to see acts of violence and goofiness. Look, I told my neighbors, I said, actually, shit, goofy and is in style right about now. Ratchet is in style. It's in style to be a ratchet bitch right about now. Have no class. Just do goofy shit. It's in style. So if this what the people want, hey, I'm not gonna do it. You know, while a lot of time I be laid back, I be by myself, cause other people doing, I be seeing people doing a little dances, everybody doing a dance and shit. I be like, even if my leg wasn't fucked up, I wouldn't jump up and be. You know, I have to be really feeling good to dance. Only time I dance, you'll catch me dancing at the going for a party. We stepping. And you might catch me then out on the floor or something. You know, me and the female. It won't be just me out there. But, you know, I be cracking up at some of these people with their little dances. And I enjoy some of it, but I have to stay in my own lane. And this seems like a lot of people need to hear that. Hey, bro, stay in your own lane. You don't have to be all over. See, and I got a problem with monkey see, monkey do, y'all. I hate to do that because it's like everybody being a follower. Everybody doing the same dance. I'm like, okay, but damn. Do y'all realize how much social media is controlling your lives? Do y'all realize that? How much they is controlling your life? That's why they call us influencers. They want to even know what we doing, what we talking about. And I got email, people want to say, hey, G, talk about this, talk about that. People want to hear you. People get used to seeing you. They want to see you. You know, because people feel like, hey, he part of the family. You know, I didn't mean to hit that button. Yeah, people feel like they part of the family. Let me see what G-Shump going for. And, I appreciate that. That's why I rock with my subscribers the way I do. You know, that's why I rock with them the way I do. Oh, and tell me, this is another thing I want to talk about. Y'all know Rick Ross had got jumped on, right? When he was up there, we're not jumped on, you know, the crowd got a little unruly when he tried to play one of Drake's songs. Well, whose song he playing? Somebody else's song in Drake Town, Kendrick Lamar's song. He tried to play one of Kendrick Lamar's songs, dissing Drake, in Canada, right? So they like, hey, bro, you ain't finna listen to that shit. They kind of snapped. Rushed him off the stage. He had to dip on out of there, right? So everybody laughing, you know, doing whatever. Bobby Smurda wants to get on there, and he laughed. He was really extra with it. Really, really extra with his laughing, y'all. Guess what Rick Ross do? Now, I didn't even know they was on tour together, but obviously they on tour together, moving around, right? Do you know Rick Ross called the promoters of the tour and said, man, he don't want Bobby Smart on the tour no more. You know, he bad for business. And would you believe they kicked that boy off that tour? And now he wanna get serious, y'all. It be coming, you felt like that. You I'm 30 something, my nigga. You could have called me. Oh, you not laughing now. It ain't funny now, huh? It's not funny now. And he said, man, my nigga, I was riding for you, man. I was on your side. No, you wasn't. You was laughing at the nigga just like he sinked it. If you was on his side, you'd been like, these pussy-ass niggas fucking with my man. They better leave my man alone, Joe. Fuck up, mad at them. They go get mad because he playing music. No, you wasn't on his side, bro. You just got caught being immature and petty. That's what's going on now, too, y'all. A lot of people is real petty about shit. And you got caught up, and Rick Ross had more juice than you, and he made that phone call. I don't want that nigga on my tour. Obviously, you wasn't headlining, Bobby. You know? So they really just had you on tour as a favor, or however it was. You know, they got you there. But if they cut you like that, they didn't need you. They probably like, shit, we don't need him. Fuck it. The music you doing is old. I don't know if you're doing your new song or not, but they kicked the man off the tour. See, watch how you do when you hurt people's feelings, ladies and gentlemen. Remember that. When you hurt people's feelings, people, you don't know how they act. You don't know how they act. And sometimes people act out violently. In this case, motherfucker got a little money in class. You know what? This nigga laughing like he think it's funny. He must don't know. I control the tour. Yeah, I don't want that nigga on tour, man. Take Bobby Smurder the fuck off the ticket. Man, we got 10 days. I don't give a fuck how many days. Tell him I'll pay him anyway. But take his ass off of the thing. And got enough money, but he said, we still gonna pay you, huh, nigga? Whatever you was making, we still gonna pay you. I just don't want to see your ass on stage. Nah, I ask you this, Bobby Smurder. Was that laugh worth that money you look at? Because you can tell it was a forced laugh. You know, you laughing and joking and you really just being annoying. You know, that's what you was doing, being annoying. That shit wasn't that funny. You know, I don't know why people would even laugh at some shit like that. This nigga damn near running for his life. He trying to get out the way so he don't get hurt. And you think that shit funny. That's not funny. To watch somebody damn near have to flee for their life. What if they start shooting? You know Rick Ross big as hell. He can't run. He a target. He might have lost a little weight, but he's still big enough. You can see there he is. Pop him in his belly. His big old ass. He ain't gonna be able to run like that. Even then, they show you he wasn't running too fast then. He had to, you know, 50 Cent call it the Great Escape. The Great Escape. You know him and 50 Cent ain't never got along, y'all. Hit that like button, y'all. 50 Cent and Rick Ross ain't never got along. And I don't know why they be just... It's just something about people, y'all. When you decide you don't like a person, then they'll just be what it is. Can't nobody tell you nothing about that person. I mean, I don't like that nigga, bro, straight up. Until he do something to make you like him, it is gonna be what it is. Hey, I don't like that nigga, period. I don't want to be around him. You know, pay attention to that, because that helped you out in life. They saying right now, one of the guys who was with Julio Fulio when he got shot, he was at his funeral. Now he's somewhere at a pool party with Young Ace them. Now, I'm like, damn, really? Damn. And you know, this is just how people play the game, back door. But ain't nobody at the back door. Julio, y'all, because he had his address and shit there. And one of the young guys who was with Julio Fulio when he was driving, you know, he said he had a little song came out, and he said, I wish I could have covered him. You know, he said, I wish I could have covered Six. He said, but we didn't see the Dirt Devil lurking. Yeah, you didn't. They weren't standing out with the guns playing, looking at you like, hey, we finna kill you. No, they was laid in the cut, for real. And they like, here this nigga come. Get ready, y'all. And them big ass guns. That is a paid murder, y'all. That's what you call a contract murder. Somebody dropped a big healthy bag on his ass. That's going to be the next thing, y'all. That's going to be the next thing. If you want to get niggas in the RICO, that's the next thing. Everybody knows somebody who done dropped a bag on a motherfucker, especially in the music industry. They drop bags like goddamn it is legal. I'm going to put some money on your head. They say it in every rap song. I'm going to put some money on your head. I'm going to put some money on your head. And try to do it. And guess what? People in the hood be trying to cash that shit in. Oh, it's money on Shrimp Head? I know what Shrimp Head right now. I just ain't that nigga. It's for real? It's for real, so? Alright. I'm serious. I know where it's baby mama stay. Let's slide over there. And motherfucker would turn your goddamn electricity off, man. About nothing. About nothing. But then again, it is about something. I just see it. It's money. You know what they say? Money is the root of all evil. Mm-hmm. Yes, it is. Money is the root of all evil. And then we was joking about something else, right? Do you know the pathway to hell was paved with good intentions? You hear me? I'm gonna say it again. The pathway to hell was paved with good intention. People plan to do good, but end up not. Sometimes things just go left, you know. We got to be accountable. Everybody need to be accountable for our own action, man. People need to stop being so petty. Please stop being so petty where you would kill your baby mama, man, and then go kill yourself. If you was that tired of living, why you didn't just kill yourself, nigga? But no, you want to make sure she go with you too. Now who go, where's your daughter? Oh, your mama and grandma and them got her. Now they gonna be feuding over this child. It ain't gonna be no love between the family because they already getting into it online. The boy who shot up the girl, his family putting up on Facebook, long live him. And the other family like, fuck that nigga. Talking about long live him, he'd still be living if he wouldn't have shot himself in the fucking head. I agree with the deceased family. Yeah, fuck that nigga. And I'm saying this, not just a YouTube, but I'm saying that how they would feel. Fuck that nigga. He wouldn't be dead if he wouldn't have shot himself in the head. Shit, so why would you put long live him? He could still be living. No, he wants to hurt his baby mama so bad. And ladies, it really bothers them when you come around looking real good and he can't have you no more. That lady probably was looking extra good that day. Got out, probably was curving, everything showing. He like, look at this bitch. Bitch, you ain't finna take the baby. I told you I'm gonna keep him extra week. I'm here to get my son now. Bitch, I'm gonna keep him an extra week. Now you not. Go get my child and they... And you see how I just start the argument? Just like that, y'all. Just like that. I'm going to keep him extra week. No, go get my motherfucking baby. No, I'm going to keep him extra week. Go get my baby. I done drove 3 hours here, nigga. I'm not finna go back without my child talking about next week. You ain't even got a car, nigga. You, how you going to come down there? No, go get my baby. And... it's crazy. It'd be just like that, y'all. And he killed this girl and all her friends in front of the baby. They said the little girl was in the fucking car. Now how you gonna shoot up a car with your woman, your baby mama and her friends and your daughter in the car? Damn. Is it that bad, y'all? Sometimes it's the drugs. Hit that like button, y'all. Do y'all think it's the drugs that's making people act so fucking weird? You know what I mean? People are acting really weird lately. They're just shoot up anything. You know, just anything. You hear that? Just anything. That's crazy. You know, and I never been out here growing up and seen all this. Some shit, you got to be smart enough to think things through on your own. Sometimes you got to say, no, I shouldn't do that. Man, I do. No, I ain't going to do that. You know, I be talking sometimes and I catch myself, no, I ain't going to say that. I might be just telling a story and I said, no, then again, no, I can't say that. Because I do know the answer to that. Because I just answered it in the last video. Sometimes you got to think. Think about what you say. Remember the shit you said. You know, you look like a damn fool. Every other day, you got a different perspective on life. Every other day. People know you so good, they could type. I know what G. Shrimp going to say. Shrimp going to probably say, fuck that nigga. You know, people get to know you like that. I can't wait to hear G. Shump say, man, fuck that nigga. Yeah, I wish I would, man. Hit that like button, man. Subscribe to the channel, man. I'll be back with y'all in the morning with another video, man. You hear me? I'm out.